Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about gun trading. You'd think it's men swapping guns. Well, that's not been the case. I have sold probably and traded as much with women as I have with men. And matter of fact, one of the rifles that I had, I just sold outright. I didn't do any trading with them. They just paid me the cash price for it, and they were buying it for their daughter. And she's like 9 years old, and it was a 243 in a Remington Model 700 243 youth model. And that just tickled me to death. And it was my personal rifle. It was the one that I used to coyote hunt with, and I also used it to deer hunt with. And it just really tickled me. And these folks drove for, I know, at least 3 hours to get to me to buy this firearm. Starting out, just to give you an idea, scopes really don't help a lot on trades or sales. I don't know if it's because people are afraid of them, afraid that maybe something's wrong with the optics, it's been dropped. It's really hard to check a scope until you put it on a firearm and test shoot it. So these really don't help a lot. A lot of times if I've got a rifle with a scope on it, and I've got it priced at, you know, $500, $600, most everybody will say, how much will you take for it without the scope? And because they've got their own scopes, the ones they trust and the ones they know that are good. This is a Glock 24. It's a 6-inch barrel, and I really liked the 6-inch, and I wanted it for hunting. So I really wasn't going to shoot any competition shooting. I wanted it for hunting, and I did take a whitetail with this, and I bet I've not shot probably 3 magazines through it. This one is one that I have up for sale or trade. This is one that I'd been wanting for the longest, and not too many people won't. It's the Ruger P89, and the reason why they don't is it's very heavy. And the reason I wanted it is this is the very first firearm that was issued to me as a police officer. And it even had the blued slide. And then later on they came back and replaced the slides for all of us with the stainless slide. Same grip, but just the stainless slide. Then later they went on to other firearms. They went into the Glock, matter of fact, the 22. But I always liked it. I asked if I could buy mine when I left, and they wouldn't let me do it. And so I've been wanting one. So I'd gotten this. I'll probably end up selling it. And then we've got this Rossi 38, which is they used to really be inexpensive. I remember the first time I bought one like this. Years ago, probably early 90s, late 80s, you could buy this pistol for about $99 because Rossi just really wasn't popular at that time. And they're almost an identical build as a Smith & Wesson, and they've become very popular, but they're not as expensive as the Smith & Wesson. This is a really good carry gun, and it's just a fabulous little five-shot 38. Now, this one is the one I traded with the trooper yesterday, and this one I'm probably going to keep. And this is the Smith & Wesson Model 642-2. It is a non-hammer, as you can see. So it's double action only. It's 5-shot, and it also will shoot the plus P's, the higher pressure. And I really like it because I don't know if you can tell, but look at that. And you know, you don't even have to have a holster for this thing, and you can carry it in your pocket and no one know you have it. As a matter of fact, I think Monday I'm gonna go for my concealed carry class. As a police officer, when you carry a gun every day for years, that's the last thing in the world you want to carry when you're off duty. Of course, we had all the extra, the handcuffs and the extra magazines and everything that was on our belt, so that added weight plus the vest. And it's just like, and like I say, I was carrying this one, and this thing, no telling what it weighs. I already should have weighed it, but I was carrying a Ruger at that time. And that was just not something I wanted to carry around with me. I did carry a little 25 for a couple of years, but that's like a pea shooter. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and do it now and go ahead and get my concealed carry due to the fact of what's been going on in our society. One thing, I do run across some really neat firearms. This is a Stoeger coach gun. It's got a nickel finish, and then it's a satin walnut. It has 2 triggers. It is really a nice firearm. The barrel is 20 inches long. It is 12 gauge and 3 inch. up to 3-inch. One barrel is the modified, which is on the right, and the left barrel is the improved cylinder, and that's the way the triggers work. The trigger in the front runs the right barrel, trigger in the back runs the left barrel. And apparently the gentleman that owned this firearm did Western reenactments, but the gun is just in pristine condition. Oh yeah, by the way, the safety is here on the front. After you know, get it loaded, you push them forward, and you can pull both triggers, one trigger, either trigger, whatever. And then when you go to eject them, they have a extractor and not a ejector. This one doesn't. The shells just release, and then you got to get them and pull the shells out. Or in competition shooting, you'll see them do like this and kick the shells out, and then throw in two more, pull it back up and fire again. But anyway, I wanted to share that with you, and I appreciate you guys so much. There's going to be links if you'd like to go and join. Thanks a lot, guys. Merry Christmas to everybody, and I hope to see you real soon.